In this video, we're gonna show you the proper attack position. What's up everyone, Tyler at the MX Factory here in Austin, Texas. Today we're gonna show you what I think is probably one of the most important things to know on a motorcycle, and that's gonna be proper attack position. We're gonna get right into it. Your foot placement on the peg is so important, mainly because it dictates where the rest of your body is on the bike. So what you wanna do is you always wanna have your foot on what we call the ball of our foot. That's gonna be in between the arch and your toes. You can move around and you can feel the differences there. The reason we want our foot there is because we want to be able to have flexion with our ankles. Okay, so this is gonna be the first point of contact with the bike's movement to your body. It's important that that contact isn't bound up. So if you go onto your arch or onto your heel, you'll notice the ankle joint is bound up, so you have no room to move your body and no room to let the heel move on the small bumps. So you're gonna feel a lot more feedback from the ground if you're riding in the wrong place on your foot. So moving up from there, you wanna kinda try to stack your pivot joints in your body, your knees and your hips, over the foot pegs, okay? The foot pegs are designed to be on the center line of the bike for a reason. The manufacturer does that to be in the most balanced point of the bike, right? So you wanna think about getting most of your body weight driven down those foot pegs, okay? So I don't necessarily straighten my knees all the way back. Some people do. I go with a micro bend. So what that means is you can lock them all the way back and then just bend them, call it an inch, so you have flexion. If you do hit something hard, your knees aren't going backwards or going forward. And from there, the hips, this is a good old Rhino quote. I really like how Rhino teaches this. You want to try to unlock your hips. So take your hips, turn them back, and basically what that's doing is unlocking your lower back and your hips where your upper body can move separately from your lower body. So it's like this right here. If your hips are turned under, now we're getting all the feedback from the foot pegs up into our lower back, which in turn gets up into our head and starts to affect our upper body control. So what we want to do is turn our hips out. That way, if the bike dances one way or another, our hips can move like that. We call it dancing with the bike often here because it happens. You got to be ready for the bike to move and be comfortable with that movement. And the way to do that is being down the center line of the bike, hips unlocked so they can move side to side, and then hinge front to back. If you think about being in good attack position, you think about being in balance with the bike. That means when you're accelerating, that means when you're decelerating. What really helps with that is being attached to the bike. The bike's going and you have loose knees and you're not connected to the bike, the bike's likely gonna go out from underneath you and then you're gonna be pulled behind the bike. Same thing under braking. If you don't have some firm knees to the bike or you're not controlling the bike with your knees, then when you're braking, it's gonna wanna push you over the front. You just kinda wanna go for a 90 degree angle with your arms. And that's gonna change, right? You're gonna sometimes be further, you're sometimes gonna be up here, but if you're just learning this, you're in your backyard or wherever is a flat space to safely learn this, just get here and ride. What you notice is that my hips are unlocked, my back is flat. When my back is flat, that means my core is turned on, so I'm using the strongest muscles in my body to hold me in place. If I do this, it turns all the front muscles off of my body, puts a lot of pressure on my lower back. Okay, so hips are unlocked, core's engaged, 90 degrees, and then what we do from there is just learn how to be in balance with the bike, meaning when we twist the throttle, we're moving forward with the bike. When we go onto the brakes, we're moving back with the bike. But right here is gonna be your natural attack position. Everything that moves from here is dictated by if the bike's accelerating or braking. We've actually got a free gift for you. We made a video for the top three secret things that we could think of to help improve your jumping. You can sign up for that down below in the description. Just put in your email and it comes right to you. Please subscribe. Subscribe and like together, which you can do them both at the same time if you have a friend.
That's a thing.
Subscribe.
That's good.
Oh man, we just come up with something. If you enjoyed this video, we've got way more over here. Don't forget to subscribe and like. I need to get my energy back up.